I'll just say it. There's a systematic disinformation campaign that is designed to convince people that they are fundamentally powerless. The education system in this country, and that extends to something that goes beyond schooling, perpetuates a message that power is primarily an external phenomenon. It doesn't exist within you. It exists somewhere outside of you. And so if you look at most people, I know we're talking about leadership, but most people don't want to be the one who's front and center. Most people don't want to be the one making the tough decisions and bearing responsibility for the consequences when those decisions don't work. Most people don't want the game-winning shot at the last second. Most people don't want to be put in a position to be criticized. It's sort of like the saying that people's number one fear is public speaking, and then death is like after that, you know? The majority of people are afraid of leadership. It reminds me that there's a cool little NBA antidote where Larry Brown, who once coached, you know, former MVP and now Hall of Famer Allen Iverson. Allen Iverson was known for shooting the ball a lot, and his teammates would complain that Iverson never passed the ball. And Larry Brown said, every time out, there would be someone who would come up to me and complain that Allen Iverson is just taking too many shots. He says, but the funny thing about that is at the end of every game, when everything was on the line and we needed one shot where if you hit it, you win and you get all the glory. But if you miss, everybody is angry at you. All of those players that would complain in those moments, they would pass the ball to Iverson and they would run in the opposite direction because they did not want the pressure and the responsibility that came with leadership. I would put most people in that category. So even if there are a lot of nefarious people out there who want to manipulate and control, that's always a minority. The majority of people are just the ones who kind of blindly follow along because they think they need to be led. So I always say the problem is not that there are greedy or dishonest politicians. The problem is that people make these politicians so relevant by not taking their own power seriously. You see, you can't have a hero unless you have a victim. You can't have a savior unless you have people who need to be saved. I don't care how much you go around being like, I'm here to save you. I'm the hero. If people feel like, yo, I'm happy with my life, I'm good. If I got something that I want, I know how to create it for myself and I'll probably do a better job than you. You won't have a job as a hero, right? So you need people to see themselves as powerless. You need people to see themselves as victims. And most people have been indoctrinated into a worldview that makes them feel like power is to be found everywhere outside of themselves. And if I can rope faith back into it for a quick second, you know, Jesus was killed because of a message like, oh no, the kingdom of God is not in this temple or in this building. The kingdom of God is within you. You and you, the tax collector, the leper, the adulteress, the marginalized, the people that are despised. Yeah, that's the open secret, guys. The kingdom of God is within you. That's where the power to change everything comes from. But Jesus, we wanted you to come and establish a physical kingdom with a military, and we wanted you to be a great political leader and overthrow the Romans. And Jesus is like, yo, I'm trying to talk to y'all about real power, a kind of power that doesn't depend on politicians, a kind of power that comes within. I know that you have been conditioned and deceived into thinking that's just a cheesy Oprah Winfrey message so that you can laugh about it when people tell you that you have power, so that you can mock them and dismiss them as a Tony Robbins wannabe. But who's laughing at you as you laugh at the idea of your own personal power? Think about that, right? And so the reason that we have this culture where everybody's looking for leaders to save them is because we have a culture where people have been educated to not take their own creative power seriously. And so people live with a permission-based mindset. And it is that mindset that makes politicians relevant. Doesn't matter how charismatic they are. Doesn't matter how dishonest they are. They would be irrelevant overnight if people took their own power seriously. And so the real first step to getting a freer society, it isn't about saying, y'all need to vote this way. Y'all need to vote that way. As long as people do not take their own power seriously, they will give away their freedom for a donut on any given day of the week. If I could wave a magic wand and instantaneously manifest a voluntarist society, freedom by its very nature will still be the sort of thing that a person can voluntarily get away. You can't call what I possess freedom if I don't have the ability to give it away in exchange for something. You know, if I can't choose my own enslavement, then how the heck am I really free? And so even if we had that freedom overnight, in a world where people didn't take their power seriously, all we would need is what we have right now. Charming politicians coming along and saying, hey, aren't you afraid? You need me. Give me your freedom and I'll give you 2 donuts. And people say, okay, yeah, well, you know, I mean, if we don't give this man our freedom, you know, how will we have donuts? And that's what we have. We have a world that's a pretty perfect reflection of that fact. You know, people don't take their power seriously. You know, which is why, you know, whether it's Socrates, I'm sorry, whether it's Socrates or Jesus, that's what we do. We kill the people who point people to the reality of their own power. And it's so funny to me that people mock self-help as this cheesy thing, but the people who get killed are always the people that point others back to their own power, which is why I say a true leader is not someone that says, follow me. A true leader is someone that points you back to the reality of your own ability to lead yourself. A true leader is someone that says, you may not know what you're doing, but neither do the people who are telling you what to do and who don't have to bear the cost of the choices that you make. You make your own choices. Oh, but people can't choose. People can't be expected to make the best decisions for themselves. And yet those same people can be expected to choose who the politicians will be. Come on.
And I think we do ourselves a great disservice when we constantly talk, oh, people are so stupid. We all do it because people are stupid. But like the point is that if you think people are stupid, it's because they have had those muscles atrophied. We can't talk about politics and we can't talk about religion because we don't talk about those things anymore.